Now, from dogs to frogs and bats to cats, our next guest is a strong contender for having the best job in the world. Check it out.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me.
Aren't they gorgeous? Now the mastermind behind those beautiful pet portraits.
Settle down.
Ken Drake and joins us now with some very adorable puppies. Now, Ken, they say never work with animals and children, and you certainly do that, but with great results. These shots are fantastic.
Oh, thanks very much, Lucy. I just love what I do, and yeah. I particularly love working with the animals. They're just what comes naturally to me, and I just love capturing their personalities.
How long does it, I mean, look at this, these beautiful shots, aren't they? How long will it take you on average to get that shot, the magic of that shot?
Oh, when we're working with our private clients, then we allow 2 hours for a session, just so we've got time for the animals to settle in and I can get to know them a bit. And then we play a bit of ball with them and give them a bit of food and start getting the photos.
Tell us about some of the quirkier pets that you've worked with.
I've worked with all sorts of animals, and not all necessarily pets, but I've had all sorts of animals in, like bats. I've had chickens in the studio. I had a chicken in with a dog last year. I've worked with koalas and kangaroos and wallabies, and I've photographed a crocodile once as well.
Did you? Yeah. How would you capture the personality of a crocodile?
Very, very carefully. They've got very big teeth when they're up close and personal.
Do you think pets, I mean, most people will attest to the fact that they think their parent, their different pets have different personalities. So how do you zero in on that pet's personality?
Oh, look, we spend a bit of time talking to their mums and dads before they come into the studio. So we've got a good idea about what the personalities are about.
Yeah.
And I spend a bit of time just playing with them and talking with them. And I think this little fella wants to go.
So very quickly, for everyone watching who adores their pets, what's the trick to taking a great photo of their pet?
Making it fun for the pet. A lot of people just kind of run after their pets with the camera, trying to get the photos, or they're shouting, sit, stays. Just make it fun. You know, get some food for them, get some toys out for them, make it interactive.
Put some sunglasses on them.
If they like that sort of thing, yeah, why not? It's a bit of fun.
Oh, well, you're doing a great job. You're obviously fantastic at what you do, and thank you for being with us today. We really appreciate it. And a big thank you to Kellyville Pets for bringing in these cute cavoodles as well. Cute as, aren't they?
I want to take one home.
That's terrific. There's the book, Ken Drake, Pawtraits.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Now, you can actually adopt one of these puppies and get yourself a copy of Ken's book, Pawtraits.
Pawtraits.
Head to our website.
I like that.